God bless you, Poplar Spring. Once again, it's Sunday morning, and we're excited about being here. I'm grateful this morning because we have some guests. Amen. We have the magnificent senior choir with us this morning, and they're going to, amen, be singing and have, amen, our Sunday school superintendent with us. Amen. And we thank God for always we have our secretary, and Finance Secretary Sister Jackson, and Brother Jackson, we want to wish him a happy birthday. Amen. And I got one of my deacons with me this morning. Deacon, amen. Curry, amen. Young, we just thank God. And Bro Bubba, amen. We're going to go start off this morning with just a word or two of a song, Jordan River, I'm Bound to Cross. I asked Senior Choir just help her with a verse or two, and we go to Joe 1 and 19 through 21. Amen. Jordan River. Put your hand together, church. Jordan River. Yeah, I'm bound to crawl. Yeah, Jordan River. Lord, I'm bound to crawl. Yeah, Jordan River, Lord, I'm bound to crawl. I got one more. Woo! River, yes I have. Let me tell you, Jordan River, Lord, I'm bound to cross. Yeah, Jordan River, church, I'm bound to cross. Yeah, Jordan River, Lord, I'm bound to cross. I got one more. Yeah, cross. Let me tell you, Jesus, he'll be waiting. Lord, he's gonna help me to crawl. Oh, Jesus, he'll be waiting. Oh, he gonna help me to crawl. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Good morning, Papa Springs. We're at the end of February, our Black History Month, and we hope that you've been enjoying everything that the youth ministry have put together for you this month. We started off with showing you clips of Black Lives Matter movement to go into our civil rights era. Then we moved to Africa with our rich history. And then this week we will be finalizing everything with telling you why our lives matter. We hope that you've enjoyed everything, and we hope that you enjoy today. Thank you.
I am Stacey Abrams, an American activist, lawyer, voting rights activist, and an author who served in Georgia House of Representatives from 2007 to 2017, serving as a ministry leader from 2011 to 2017. I was born December 9th, 1973.
Hi, I am Brianna Taylor. I was born June 5th, 1993. I am an emergency technician, but sadly, on March 13th, 2020, I was shot and killed in my own home. I am Brianna Taylor.
Good evening. I want to see young people in America embody the spirit of the 60s. I want you to find a way to get in the way. Be bold, be courageous, be vigilant. I want you to find a way to get into trouble, good trouble, necessary trouble. My name is John Lewis, and my life matters.
I am an African-American award-winning film, television, and stage actress. I built a successful career by carefully choosing roles that exemplifies quality. I was born in New York City on December 19, 1924. In 1963, I was the first African-American to star in a TV drama. I am Cicely Tyson, and my life matters.
There is always light. If only we're brave enough to see it, if only we're brave enough to be it. I am Amanda Gorman, and my life matters.
I'm Raphael Warnock, and I approve this message because I was the first Black senator from Georgia. And I like puppies.
I can't breathe. My name is George Floyd. My love,
not to. Hi, I'm the first Black female vice president. My name is Kamala Harris. My life matters.
You tell me that my life matters, but how? Please tell me how. Stand tall. Don't slouch. Hold your head up. Know your worth. Don't wear a hoodie. Speak like you have some sense. I did all those things, and my life still doesn't matter to them. They make it hard for me to believe that my life matters. When you're thrown on a ship, when you're tied together and lay in your own filth and then sold like you're a dog. When you're told to go through the back door, sit in the back of the bus, go to your own schools, our life didn't matter. How can our lives matter if they don't even think that we need to breathe? When you're forced to the ground with a knee on your neck until you take your last breath, how can it matter? When I can't even sleep in my own bed safely, when people who are supposed to protect me burst into my house and kill me while I'm asleep, only to be arrested for disturbing my neighbors. How? Please tell me how. How can it matter when I can't even walk home eating Skittles or go for a run in my neighborhood without being beaten or shot? How can my life matter? Please tell me when I'm arrested, tasered, scorned just for standing up for what's right. Go to college, get a degree, get a nice job, make something of yourself. I did all that, and for some reason, my life still doesn't matter to them. Own, don't rent, have good credit, save some money, be your own boss. Did all that too. And to them, my life still doesn't matter. But yes, my life does matter. Because if it didn't, they would not be so afraid of us. Afraid of our beautiful chocolate skin. Afraid of our ideas, our athleticism, our creativity, our boldness. Afraid that one day we may remember who we really are. We matter. We have 3,000 years of history. We didn't start as a victim, a slave. We were kings and queens. We created our own communities, our own government. We were the first doctors, engineers, farmers, mathematicians, astrologers, teachers. Oh, we definitely matter. We will continue to rise to become future presidents, future vice presidents, continue to be the best on every field, on every court. We will continue to make our mark and shape this world in the way that it should be. Oh, yes, we matter. And every day we will do everything we can so that everyone remembers that our lives matter.
Hallelujah!
But thank God I have food to eat.
Hallelujah! hope it blesses me.
Yes,
Lord, Lord, Lord.
You've been blessing me.
You've been blessing me.
I can tell the world.
Tell the world that I am blessed. I am blessed.
Saturday, we just looking forward to a wonderful time, amen, all day long. This morning, there is a word from the Lord, and not a long word, but something from King James Version, and Job 1 and 19 through 21. It said, behold, there came a great wind from the cone in the wilderness, and smote the four corners of the house. And it fell upon the young men, and they are dead. And I only am escaped alone to tell thee. A runner came to Job and told him that. And Job 1 and 20 said, then Job arose, amen, and ripped, amen, his melon, amen, and shaved his head, and fell down upon the ground and worshiped, amen. He fell down and he first of all, he cried and he worshiped. Amen. The Bible said, and said, naked came I out of my mother's womb, and naked shall I return hither. Amen. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. May God bless the reading of these words for the good edification of our hearts, our mind, and our soul. This morning, we want to talk about praising God through problems.
Amen.
And there's something, praising God through problems. A lot of time, amen, a lot of people, they believe in giving God all the praise and clapping their hand and excited when things are going well. But when problems come, sometimes, amen, they fall and they, amen, they don't know what to do. They don't understand how they're going to make it through it, amen, because a problem. But I'm here to tell you, problem is a part of life.
Amen.
I don't care who you are, amen. If you haven't had a problem, just keep on holding on.
Amen.
The problem's going to come, amen. But one thing I do know, I know a problem solved. His name is Jesus, amen. And I want you to know, amen, he'll take care of whatever you're going through. I'm talking this morning about a young man by the name of Job. The Bible said Job was a righteous man, A man who is shunning evil. He believed in doing the right thing. But on one occasion, amen, God had summoned all the brothers and all the spiritual Christians together, and this devil showed up. And Elijah asked, what did you come here for? He said, I'm walking to and fro, up and down, looking for whom I can devour. And Lord said, well, have you considered my servant Job? Yeah. Let me tell you, in the church, you may not have everybody with you, but you got one somebody that you can depend on. Can I get a witness? Yeah. Amen. I don't care how many folks in the church, don't you ever think everybody with you. Yeah. So right here we find the Lord said, amen, I got one that I can depend on. Name Job. Yeah. Amen. Who he shunned evil. And Job is a trustworthy and a good man. Yeah. Amen. And the devil said, well, if you take the hedge I'm riding, I'll make it cuss you to your face. Yeah. Amen. But the Lord told him, go ahead. And for time, amen, all kind of, let me tell you something. Whenever the Lord stepped back, getting ready for problem. Problem gonna come, amen. Everything that could ever happen to Job started happening. Amen. The Bible said, first of all, he lost his cattle. He lost his sheep. He lost his goats. He lost every sheep. He lost everything that he had. Amen. Job lost it all. And now that after he lost everything, Job got sick. So sick until he flushed. Began to fall from his bone. So the story go on. I need you to read it. It's a good story. But now Job lost, amen, everything. All his children, his animals, his wealth, his health. But after hearing all the news, Job 1 and 20 tells us, he fell to the ground, amen, and worshiped the Lord through his problem. He fell to the ground. Now, when you're going through, amen, you know, I'm serious now. When you're going through, sometimes you don't think about different things, amen. But Job, amen, even though Job was going through Thelma, he still recognized that the Lord gave it and the Lord take it away. And whatever you have, everything you have, God gave it to you. Everything you know, he taught you. Everywhere you go, he takes you. So everything we have, the Lord does it for. So Job, amen, fell to the ground. Amen. And he worshiped the Lord in his problem. But the Bible said that, listen, Job's wife, maybe wasn't as strong as he was. The Bible said, Job's wife, amen, said to him, does not thou still retain the Lord, amen, integrity, amen, and all this has happened? You need to cuss God and die. In other words, he ain't done nothing for you. Cussing and die. But the Bible said, Job said unto her, amen, thou speakest as a one who are foolish, a foolish woman, amen. What shall we not, amen, receive evil in all this? Amen, Job said, did not Job sin, amen, with his lip? No. But he said this him, shall we accept good from God and not evil? Let me explain that. What Job was saying, God does good things for us.
Yes.
Wake us up in the morning.
Yes.
Clothe us.
Yes.
Help us to get new homes and new cars. So you mean to tell me God do all the good and you don't think no bad will show up?
Yes.
Let me tell you something. Bad will show up.
Yes.
You don't have to order bad. You don't have to call bad up. You don't have to, amen, go to the YouTube and get it. Bad just show up by itself.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
Amen. I never will forget one day, amen, I ride in my car. I got a call, amen, from Sister Belinda Scott. Crying, know what was going on. And that, I mean, with nothing, all of a sudden, her little grandson got drowned. You don't never know where trouble is.
Amen.
Can I get a witness? You don't never know where bad is.
Right.
But bad will show up.
Yeah.
So Job let him know, you mean to tell me we can expect good, but not good? We can expect good, but not evil. In other words, what Job was saying, all the good things God had done. God gave us the cattle that we lost, he gave it to us.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The house we have, he gave it to us.
Yeah.
the sheep, the goats, he gave it to her. And if he gave it, he can do it. Take it away. God bless you. Amen. He can take it right back from us. Amen. You know, ask yourself, amen, do the problem you face in life make you stronger or do they make you weaker? Amen. My brother and sister, problems make you strong.
Yeah.
Because problems will learn how to get you on your knees.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness here?
Yeah.
Amen. Sometimes problems give, amen, the experience of seeing God, amen, come through with each problem. Amen. We learn we can trust in his word. Amen. Every problem, amen, sister Willie, it get me closer to the Lord.
Yeah.
It would be great, listen, it would be great if one, we could accept Jesus as our Savior, and life was just one easy cruise. Just cruise right on in hell. No problem, no sickness, no hurt, no pain. It'd be great. Amen. That would be, make life very comfortable. But my brother and sister, everyone would want to, amen, become a Christian if they know they ain't got no problem at all. But you're going to have some problems. I used to thought before I became a minister, amen, Thelma, I never would have thought that me and Sister Punna still have some little argument. You know, I'm preaching there. Argument is over. To my surprise, preachers argue too.
Amen.
Can I get a witness? Amen. Preacher wife argue too.
Amen.
So problem going to be there.
Amen.
Yeah, they're going to be there. Amen. So my brother and sister, everyone, amen, would want to go to heaven, as I said, if they know they were problem free. But heaven, having faith in Jesus does not take away your problem. The Bible says even though his wife had advised him to cuss God and die, he said to her, accept, amen. He said, look, accept good from God, amen, and not trouble. In other words, should we accept good from God and not trouble? What a response that he had. Job later complained, amen. He never complained about something, but if you look over into the story, Job did have a word he spoke. He accepted that God had never changed. And I want you to know we serve an unchanging God.
Yes.
I said we serve an unchanging God.
Yes.
He wakes us up every day.
Thank
amen.
You.
Put us to sleep every night.
Yes.
Feed us and clothe us.
Yes.
Amen. That's what he do. Job, amen, knew that God was still with him and that he still cared.
Yes.
Let me help you, and I'm about through. Though it wasn't long. Job realized, even though I got problems, the Lord is still with me.
Yes,
amen.
Even though I'm going through some things, the Lord is still with
yes,
me.
Yes, Lord.
My sister-in-law and her best friend, they went shopping a couple weeks ago. And they came back, and my sister-in-law friend took her home, and then she went home. And she called my Betty and told her, Betty, you ain't gonna believe what happened. She walked in the house, and her husband was laying on the floor dead. My brother and sister, we don't know where problems is.
Amen.
We don't know where trouble is.
Amen.
But I want you to know the Bible said, he, amen, the Lord will never leave us. Amen. Job knew that God was still with him even though he had lost everything.
Everything.
Not some things, Sister Willie, but everything.
Everything.
His children.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
His cows. Amen. His sheep, his goats. Everything. And the last thing up was his wife.
Yeah.
Because when she said, cuss God die, she was gone too.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness? Most of us praising, our praise is not our first response in difficult situations.
Yeah.
I'm going to say that again. Most of us praise is not our response in a difficult situation. Sometimes we use them funny words. And, amen. Sometimes we look at folks crazy. Don't watch it. We want to start a fight. Amen. When something happens.
That's right.
Amen. But sometimes, amen, the pain of the circumstances is so overwhelming. We lunch out, amen, in fear. And we lunch out in anger.
Free crap.
But my brother and sister, I went to tell you, amen, we got to learn how, amen, to praise God.
Yes.
In spite of our problems. We got to learn how to praise him in spite of our hurt. We got to learn how to praise him in spite of our pain. We got to learn how to praise him in spite of losing a loved one, we still got to praise the Lord. Amen. When I watched Job's situation, and I read it, amen, last week, and as I was reading this week, when I watching Job's story, I want you to read the whole story. Job responded, reminded me that God is still present in spite of our pain. I don't know if anybody here this morning know what I'm talking about, but in spite of your problem, God is still present.
Amen.
In spite of what you're going through, God is still present. When the disciples was out on that ship, and the ship and the waves came and the wind came, amen, the Lord was walking out on the water to meet them, to let them know he was still with them.
Yes, Lord.
So my brother and sister, when we watch, amen, the situation that Job went through, it ought to make us stronger. It ought to make us look to the hills from which come our help.
Yes, yes.
Amen. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. The Bible said that, amen, he will help us through our hard time as well as our good time.
Yes.
The Lord prepare me, amen, and prepare up for the time when praise is most difficult to do.
Yes.
So this morning, I want to say to Poplar Spring, we're going through a pandemic.
Yes.
A lot of us are going through, amen, a lot of things. A lot of people have lost their job, lost their homes, and lost their wealth and their finance. And some of them have lost loved ones and lost lives.
Yes.
Me and my wife both lost our baby sister. Amen. But still, we're holding on.
Amen.
You know why? Because we know how to praise God through our problems. I don't know about you this morning, but one of the best things that you can do in life when you're going through something, continue to praise God.
Amen.
You got to continue to praise him.
Amen.
I thank God for Sister Scott. She's getting ready to take a long trip to Texas. Amen. And that's the last place anybody want to go right now. But she realized that I got a loved one up there, and I got to go take care of him. You know what she's doing? She's praising him through the problem.
Yeah.
Now come on somebody, because I'm going to tell you, it take a lot for me to go to Texas right now. Can I get a witness? But she praised him through a prop. So I want to thank you, amen, Sister Scott, for teaching me and teaching us, amen, in spite of the weather up there, I got a loved one. And my job is to make sure it's all right. Well, that's where the Lord is. When we are going through things, when we are going through our pain, the Lord see our problem, and the Lord come to our rescue.
Yeah.
God bless you. God come to our rescue. I don't know about you this morning, but I thank God for Job teaching me how to praise God through my problem. If you got a problem this morning, out in radio and in the TV land, if you got a problem, amen, you out there on YouTube, amen, I want to tell you, you can still praise God. You can still praise him. You can still praise him through your problem. Can I get a witness here? Somebody say yes. Hallelujah. Still praise him through your problem. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Hold my mute. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. God bless you. Drop your head. Father, we thank you this morning for the word of God. Thank you for teaching us how to praise you through our problem. Because all of us have them. And we don't have them now, we will have them. So Lord, and through this pandemic situation that we're going through, a lot of people, we found out, amen, over 500,000 people have lost their lives. And oh Lord, but for some reason or another, you keeping us holding on. And we want to thank you for that.
Thank you.
Amen, because it could have been us. But Lord, you look beyond our fault, and you saw our needs. And we thank you for it.
Thank you.
And we glorify your holy name.
Yes.
Have mercy right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Our Lord and Savior, let every heart say amen.
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 And amen.
Amen.
This morning we want to thank you. It's 4th Sunday. Amen. Black history. And I thank God I have the amen. Senior choir gonna be singing. They already done sung once, they're gonna sing again. And we just thank God for them being with us today, dressed in their African attire. Amen. Looking real good. Amen. Looking like Mashita Bieber. Amen. But we just thank God for them. Amen. This morning, amen, I would, if you get your supper ready. It is Communion Sunday. And we're going to ask, amen, at this time, amen, Brother Render, give us amen, the decree concerning, amen, our communion. And after you give the decree, we will come back and we will take our supper.
Good morning. Reading from the NIV, 1 Corinthians chapter 11, beginning at verse 23. For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this, whenever you drink it, in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he come. So then, whoever eat the bread or drink the cup of the Lord in unworthy manner will be guilty of sinning against the body and blood of the Lord. Everyone ought to examine themselves before they eat of the bread and drink from the cup. For those who eat and drink without concerning the body of Christ and drink bring judgment on themselves. That is why many among you are weak and sick, and a number of you have fallen asleep."
Thank you, Reverend Rundle, for giving us the decree this morning. We appreciate that. I would if all of you take your bread as I bless it this morning. Father, bless this supper as we, amen, come together to partake of it. Pray if you take your hands of mercy and change it from a common use to a spiritual use. Bless the bread, O Heavenly Father, which is the body of Christ. Bless the wine, the blood of Jesus. Bless it in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus was with his disciples, and he took unleavened bread, and amen, looked to his disciples, broke it and blessed it, said, "Take ye, this is my body," to ate together. After eating, Jesus took the cup, amen, poured up, gave it to them, wine, which represented his blood, told them, "Let's drink together," and they drank. After drinking, Jesus told them, "Go ye therefore unto the mountain of Olives, tarry ye there till I come." He's coming back again. You may not believe it, but the Lord is on his way back. So I pray that everyone, amen, amen, set your house in order. Because we don't know when he's coming, but he's coming back again. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you, Papa Spring. Let me say before we leave the air, amen, we thank God for all of you once again this morning. And I want to tell you about a few announcements that we need to tell you. First of all, let me say that today, amen, around about 2 o'clock, go have a Zoom, amen, and you can, amen, watch it, amen. It's going to be from the Sunday School Drama Ministry, amen, and we want you to watch it, amen, around about 2 o'clock. Sister Gloria Carey and Sister Linda Grant, they are coordinators of it, and they will also have prizes for Black History, amen, questions they're going to be asking. And remember to dress in your African attire. So we're looking forward to it. Thank you, Sister Willie. But even though I want to say to the senior choir, I want you to come up with something. Whatever you come up with, Sister Willie and Sister Jack can show you how to do it on Zoom. We want the devil to know you ain't going to stop us. Amen. Stopped us last year, but this year it ain't going to work. We want to move forward in spite of. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
Don't forget, we still have our prayer line, 1-339-209-5770. Amen. You call in on Wednesday night, 6:45, so we can get in line. Amen. Amen. Call in. Amen. And we start off by 7 o'clock. Don't forget, amen, that we are, amen, want you to call. If you got a scripture, favorite scripture you'd like to give, give your favorite scripture. Amen. And certainly we enjoy. I want you to be in prayer for the Atlanta Missionary Baptist Association, AMBA. Amen. Bless Papa Spring Church family and all our leadership, all the people that's in charge of different ministry in our church. Bless our country and our entire nation. Amen. Our president, our new president, President Joe Biden. We ask that be in prayer for him and our vice president, President Harris. Amen. Amen. The first Black vice president we ever had. So we're looking forward, amen, to their ministry. Amen. Being proud of them. Amen. Also, be in prayer for all the mothers at Poplar Spring. Every one of them, amen. Certainly, we've had some been sick, amen. But the Lord is still in the blessing business. Mother Tony's back up and at it and doing better. And we thank God. I was glad to hear Mother Thomas the other day, Sunday school. Amen. So our mothers are coming back up. Continue to bless Sister Brinkley and Sister, amen, Sankfield and all the mothers at our church. Amen. Glad to see Sister Thelma, and we ask that you be in prayer for Dot and all the rest of them. There are many people in our church been a little sick, but thank God they are mending right now. So we thank God for that. They've been asking me many times about how we could give at Poplar Spring. Certainly, I want to say to the senior choir, I'm going to get with Sister Willie and some of the rest of the people one day next week. We got a little money from the steel, and not as much as I thought we would get, but we got some. Amen. And so we want to paint. We want to hope to redo the pew. We want to put some new carpet down and just make the church look good. When we come back in, it's going to be a new thing. Amen. Amen. Going to be a new thing. So we need to have a meeting and talk about it. We'll try to get some prices and, amen, see what we can do to make Poplar Spring look beautiful. You want your house to look good. We ought to make sure God's house look good. Amen. Some of you may want to know how you can give. You can send it through USP mail. You can log in on your website, www.psbcellenwoodgeorgia.org, and click on Give. A download Giveify app on your mobile phone, and you will see, amen, my picture. Not only that, add to your bill of pay, and it will come through the mail. Insert it. Also, you can come and up to the church and insert it, amen, in a secure lockbox that's on the door, church door. And certainly, we'll get it. So we ask that you please, ma'am, please, sir, amen, let us continue to give. The Lord has blessed us. At Poplar Spring, we're still standing, and we're still holding on. So we ask that if you get, I ask the first Sunday morning, those of you that can, let's give a little bit more so we can try to do some of the things that we want to do here at the church, like carpet and all that, even though we got a little money from the iron. But it wasn't as much as I thought we would get because now people are always trying to, you know, get more from you than you get from them. But through the grace of God, we thank God for what we did get, and we praise God for that. So I want to say, as I get ready to close, and even thank the senior choir again for doing such a wonderful job today, and we pray that God will just continue to bless us. Look at somebody and say, you know what? We're still standing. God bless you. All right, Senior Choir.
Amen.
Let me sit out here and listen to you. I ain't heard you in a good while.